Anderson with the winner. But of course, that would only affect Jerry Quarry, since Joe Orbillo, after this fight, is ticketed for duty in the Army in the Far East. The fact that in an era where some boxers, some people, feel that they should not represent the United States in the armed services, it has been refreshing for Southern California fans to know the story of Joe Orbillo, who, also a very promising fighter, volunteered for duty, and now, after his trip, possibly for Vietnam. As we said, Orbillo is the underdog, 10-7, Quarry the favorite. Quarry considered to have the most or more potent punch, the left hook. But Orbillo fights like a tiger and has always employed better style to the body than has Quarry. And it's been an issue that has burned for 2 years here in Los Angeles. Which fighter is the better? And you can be sure that the fans here tonight have come to vocally support the man they favor. There'll be a lot of noise.
Quarry that you could hear at ringside despite the noise. It is the left hook of Quarry that is his most lethal weapon. Orbillo probably, according to those in the gymnasium, throws the better combination and will work to the body as much as Quarry will allow him to. The 1965 National Golden Gloves heavyweight champion. He knocked out every opponent in the finals. Orbillo did not fight in the Golden Gloves, was a junior Golden Glover, fought at the age of five, as did Quarry. They've known each other for a long time. Orbillo, an all-conference football center one in high school, a police science major at a junior college, Harvard Junior College in the Southern California area. Quarry, an all-star third baseman as a junior baseball star. Two very talented young athletes. Quarry 21, Orbillo only 20.
Roger. My left hand lower his body. Give the body when he's getting the rope. You want to give it to him on that body.
Thank you, Jake, very much.
Two young heavyweights. Quarry told me during the week that he respected most the left jab of Orbillo. He says he just amazes him that he can get so much sting on the jab. That Cassius Clay is the only man who may be able to throw that left hand with more punishment. Orbillo has not used it much thus far. And of course, Quarry has a fantastic left hook, and he has knocked out many opponents with just one swat of that left hand. You wonder, Mickey, if they'll have anything left at the other end of this 10-rounder.
Well, he thinks they started off fast for two big fellows. Joe's sporting a little mouse under his left eye. Scored by Jerry Quarry. Inside, Orbillo has been in a great left hook for Jerry Quarry in the midsection of the Bulls in California. That's the end of round three.
On the left, and Terry Quarry, and those two stinging left hooks to the body by Quarry at the end of round three showed their effect as Orbillo grimacing as he headed for his corner at the end of round three. Quarry countering well with that left hand. Orbillo driving him away, and it's Orbillo who is fighting the less controlled fight. He's just fighting in a manic way, more so than we've ever seen him, whereas Quarry, in the sports terminology, is maintaining his cool. Seems to be waiting for his opportunity.
Pull back in the straight line with his hands to the side. He's asking for
here today. Left hook.
Larry Quarry in that fifth round, and Orbillo did just what his punter wanted him to do. He did stay away.
He said, I'll mind a fire, Dick. As we go into the corner, we're looking in the corner to Orbillo. He's facing him in the ring as his manager, Jake Chabrou. On the other side of the ring, you see the back of John Flores, the co-manager of young Jerry Quarry.
Fighters have the reputation of running out of gas in the late round. We'll see as we approach round six. Round six. Private first class Joe Orbillo in the lighter red front and navy velvet blue Jerry Quarry. Back in their chairs with a feeling that it is Corey's fight to deal with it as he pleases. But if Orbillo should be able to take off the effects of round four, he's ever dangerous, and you won't find a more courageous athlete anywhere. Not only two outstanding athletes, but it's a shame that the entire nation does not know more personally Joe Orbillo and Jerry Quarry. We're blessed with two outstanding young men. And they have represented their sport so very well. They deserve much of the credit for the big crowds that have come back to boxing in Southern California. These two young men right here, they've been a part of it all. combination by Quarry. 1 minute gone in round seven. Quarry Barrage. Quarry showing the confidence that he has not always shown in the past. He appears to be in full physical and emotional command. Second of round eight.
every round.
Down the final 6 minutes. To be somewhat cautious. He certainly has piled up enough points at this stage to hold a considerable margin over Orbillo, although Orbillo did, in the eyes of some, win the early round, up until round four. Future bout with ex-heavyweight champion Floyd Patterson. Joe Orbillo, private first class, his last fight for perhaps 2 years as he heads to the Far East. It's been a game effort by Orbillo, but it has been a night through the first 9 rounds for Jerry Quarry. Oh, yeah.